people know what NPS, Net Promoter Score. And
explain.
What NPS is.
Yes.
So we send basically a simple survey. Would you recommend us? Which would give us one between 0 and 10. And then they can come with comments on that. And we follow up on those comments.
So and really how does that become Net Promoter Score?
How it become Net Promoter Score?
Yeah.
So you get a number.
And that's your Net Promoter Score?
Yes. And the top one is Apple, I think, at the moment.
Okay.
But we're doing pretty well.
Does she deserve the Buddha thing?
Yes, she does.
Sorry, hello, where are you? Excuse me. You get a Buddha FM radio.
And loop.
Yeah, you don't sound like you want it.
I want to.
All right, she does. That's right, that's right.
Whoops.
Okay, last question. Have you got any left? There's one left. The original. Yeah?
There you go. Different businesses have different cost of customer acquisition. At what point does it... should businesses start using Zendesk? That, you know, some businesses cost a lot to get customers for more. Twitter costs quite cheap, so.
I don't think it matters. You need to service your customers well, no matter. Even people who get things for free, they still view you as their vendor and they view themselves as a customer. And their voice, if they go on Twitter or Facebook, can be amplified both positively and negatively. So you should treat everybody well. So we have some, let me come an example. So I was working in the weekend in San Francisco, and this guy from The Point reached out with a question, and I answered him, and then about a couple of months later I went to Chicago and they flipped, and there weren't free students and this guy anymore, but they called Groupon. So you know, we treated him well, and it's a very large customer.
So there's some point where customer service kind of blends into branding, or
it's the same thing.
Yeah.
So it's like Napoleon runs around, you know, introducing everybody. That's kind of his customer service. That's his brand, and he's very, very good at it.
That was my point: is that customer service is not a single thing, right? When you talk to marketers, they talk about single customer view, they talk about post-sales, pre-sales, that's like bollocks. Can't you just...
And particularly for us as a business, as a software as a service, it's lifetime value.
Very nice. All right, so we're going to do a lucky draw now, and the winner gets what? Doesn't get lucky catch. The shirt. Can you open it so they can see in its full glory?
So this is from we have an iPad version, Android version, and iPhone radio. Even we have an SDK. We also had a Windows Phone version, but nobody uses Windows Phone.
So what that says to me is Aaron in Coach Surf South. Where's Aaron gone?
He's gone already.
All right. Yeah, that means you go and hang out on people's sofas. That means you go up to Mount Fuji.
So you can
don't forget your toilet paper.
You can work from anywhere. So this is for the launch of the iPad version number 5 or something of it. So yeah, you can work on the toilet.
There is, yeah, I'm not going to comment on that.
Okay.
What does it say on the back?
It says
Zendesk.
all right, let's do the lucky draw. Come on, ready? Ooh, this moment I can feel the tension in the room.
Close your eyes.
Stop cheating. You've got massive hands. Can you like it?
Can't
yeah, who designed this? All right, and the winner is?
One Sky, Bianca Ho.
Bianca, are you here?
I'm
here. Bianca gets a t-shirt. Woo! So, and an FM radio and a t-shirt, aren't you lucky? So on, let's have a little photo with the t-shirt. You don't have to put it on now, but you can stand in front.
So I will keep your card if that's okay, and I'll send you a little swag pack with a female size t-shirt.
She might want a male size, mate.
So this is for
Come on. No, up there, little photo session. Don't trip on the cable.
One, two, one more. One, two, three.
All right. Thank you. And a big round of applause to Michael. That was a good job. We're allowed to hang out here for another hour. No, another 45 minutes. But before that, I just want to let you know, during Start Me Up Week, we're going to do, where's end here?
And I'm interviewing the founder of YoBB, which is a Chinese meta search engine that just got sold to Skyscanner. Does anybody in this room use Skyscanner? If you're looking to do a trip, really good app. So the CEO, who has a business in Hong Kong in Shenzhen, is going to talk about starting a startup in Hong Kong but using developers in Shenzhen. So on November the 12th, we'll have lots of start me up people. Okay, so please feel free to hang out for an hour or so, then we have to get out of here. All right, thank you very much.
Music.
They will be playing mostly stuff by Bob Dylan, The Grateful Dead, and God knows what else. Yeah. And the show is going to start 9:30, and it will be $100 all you can drink till you drop, okay? Just because you're a Wet Wednesday fan, you get to hear this first, okay? Bye-bye.
Thank you.
So it's really interesting with this stuff.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm just going to go over everything. Thank you.